Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we understood the basics of the Fourier transform. So in this video, we will see the Fourier transform of some useful functions. And the first function is the unit impulse function. So this unit impulse function is 0 everywhere except at time t is equal to 0. And if you see this function at t is equal to 0, then actually it is undefined. But when we integrate this unit impulse function from minus infinity to plus infinity, then its value is equal to unity. So this unit impulse function can be visualized as very narrow rectangular pulse of the unit area. And here, this epsilon tends to 0. So if we see the area of this rectangular pulse, then it is equal to unity. Now let's see what happens when we multiply this unit impulse function with some another function. Let's say there is some function phi of t which is continuous at time t is equal to 0. Now since the impulse function only exists at time t is equal to 0, so when we multiply it with another function phi of t, then we get phi of 0, that is the value of the function phi of t at time t is equal to 0. That means the multiplication of the unit impulse function with this function phi of t is equal to phi of 0 times delta t. Similarly, when we multiply this time shifted impulse function, that is delta t minus t, with this phi of t, then we get phi of t times delta t minus t. And this unit impulse function is very useful because of its sampling property. So when we multiply this impulse function with another function phi of t and integrate it from minus infinity to plus infinity, then it gives the value of the function at time t is equal to 0. So let us see that. Now we know that when we multiply the function with the unit impulse function, then it is equal to the value of the function at time t is equal to 0 times delta t. Now this phi of 0 is constant, so we can take it out. And we know that when we integrate this delta t from minus infinity to plus infinity, then its value is equal to 1. That means the overall value of this integration is equal to phi of 0. That means in this way, we got the value of this function phi of t at time t is equal to 0. So that is the sampling property of this unit impulse function. Similarly, when we multiply this time shifted unit impulse function with another function phi of t and integrate it from minus infinity to plus infinity, then we get the value of this function at time t is equal to capital T. So now, let us see the Fourier transform of this unit impulse function. So we know that the Fourier transform of any function is equal to integration minus infinity to plus infinity times the function itself times e to the power minus j omega t dt. Now as we have seen, when we multiply the delta function with any other function and integrate them over minus infinity to plus infinity, then we get the value of that function at time t is equal to 0. So for the given integration, we get the value of this exponential at time t is equal to 0, that is e to the power 0, and that is equal to 1. That means the Fourier transform of this unit impulse function is equal to 1. And graphically, if we see this in the frequency domain, then it will look like this. Similarly, in the frequency domain, if we have a unit impulse function, then in the time domain, we get the DC signal with amplitude of unity. So to get that, let us take the inverse Fourier transform of this unit impulse function. And we know that the inverse Fourier transform can be given as integration minus infinity to plus infinity, the function times e to the power j times 2 pi ft times df, that is equal to e to the power 0. That means whenever we take the inverse Fourier transform of this unit impulse function, then it is also equal to unity. And in the time domain, the function will look like this. So that is the inverse Fourier transform of the unit impulse function. Then another very useful function is the unit step function. So the value of this unit step function is 1 when t is greater than or equal to 0, and this function is 0 for t less than 0. So we will see the Fourier transform of this unit step function little later. But when a continuous time function is multiplied with this unit step function, then that particular function exists only for t greater than or equal to 0. And one such function is the exponential function. So here, this a is greater than 0. So as you can see, when we multiply this e to the power minus at with this unit step function, then this function exists only for t greater than or equal to 0. And later on, we will use this function to define another useful function. So first of all, let us find the Fourier transform of this function. So the Fourier transform of this e to the power minus at ut can be given as integration minus infinity to plus infinity e to the power minus at times u of t times e to the power minus j times 2 pi ft times dt. And since the function exists for t greater than or equal to 0, so we can write it as integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus at times e to the power minus j times 2 pi ft times dt. That is equal to integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus a plus j 2 pi f times dt. That is equal to minus 1 divided by a plus j 2 pi f times e to the power minus a plus j 2 pi ft with limit from 0 to infinity. Now when we put the limit infinity, then this e to the power minus infinity is equal to 0. And this e to the power 0 is equal to 1. That means this integration is equal to minus 1 divided by a plus j 2 pi f times 0 minus 1. That is equal to 1 divided by a plus j times 2 pi f. So this is the Fourier transform of this function e to the power minus at times u of t. Similarly, if we have another function that is e to the power at times u of minus t, that is this function, then its Fourier transform will be equal to 1 divided by a minus j times 2 pi f. Or if we write it in terms of the omega, then it is equal to 1 divided by a minus j omega. While for this function, it is equal to 1 divided by a plus j omega, where omega is equal to 2 pi f. So we will use these two functions for deriving the Fourier transform of another useful function. And that function is the signum function. So this is the graphical representation of the signum function. And as you can see, the value of this function is 1 for t greater than 0, and it is equal to minus 1 for t less than 0. And at time t is equal to 0, its value is equal to 0. So to find the Fourier transform of any function, the function should be absolutely integrable. That means it should follow this condition. But if you see this signum function, then it does not satisfy this condition. But still we can find the Fourier transform by considering the signum function as the summation of the two exponentials. So if you see over here, this e to the power minus at times ut represents this function, while minus of e to the power at times u of minus t can be represented by this function. And when this a tends to 0, then these two functions can be represented by almost straight lines. So when we represent this signum function as the summation of the two exponentials, then we can find the Fourier transform of this signum function. So now, let us find the Fourier transform of the signum function using this expression. So we can write this expression as limit a tends to 0, the Fourier transform of this function, that is e to the power minus at times ut minus Fourier transform of e to the power at times u of minus t. Now we know that the Fourier transform of this function is equal to 1 divided by a plus j 2 pi f. Similarly, the Fourier transform of this function is equal to 1 divided by a minus j 2 pi f. So from this, we can write this expression as limit a tends to 0, 1 divided by a plus j 2 pi f minus 1 divided by a minus j 2 pi f. That is equal to limit a tends to 0, a minus j 2 pi f minus of a plus j 2 pi f divided by a square plus 2 pi f whole square. That is equal to limit a tends to 0 minus j times 4 pi f divided by a square plus 2 pi f whole square. And when we put the limit a tends to 0, then we can write this expression as minus j times 4 pi f divided by 4 pi square f square. And if we simplify it, then we can write it as 1 divided by j times pi f. Or if we write it in terms of the omega, then it is equal to 2 divided by j omega. That means the Fourier transform of the signum function is equal to 2 divided by j omega, or it can be written as 1 divided by j times pi f. And with the help of the signum function, we can find the Fourier transform of the unit step function. The thing is, this unit step function is also not integrable, but using the signum function, we can find the Fourier transform. So this unit step function can be expressed as 1 by 2 times this signum of t plus 1. That means when we add this 1 to the signum function, then this minus 1 will get cancelled out. And if we just take the half of the entire term, then we will get this unit step function, right? So now, let us find the Fourier transform of this function. So from this, we can write it as 1 by 2 times the Fourier transform of this signum function plus Fourier transform of this 1. Now we know that the Fourier transform of the signum function is equal to 2 divided by j omega, right? While the Fourier transform of the 1 is equal to delta f. So from this, we can write it as 1 divided by j omega plus 1 by 2 times delta f. Or we can write it as 1 divided by j times 2 pi f plus 1 by 2 times delta f. So this is the Fourier transform of the unit step function. So in this way, using this signum function, we can find the Fourier transform of this unit step function. Alright, so now let us see the Fourier transform of the rectangular function. So mathematically, it can be expressed as rect of t divided by tau. That means this rectangular pulse or this rectangular function is 1 when the t is less than tau by 2. And it is equal to 0 for the value of t which is greater than tau by 2. So let us find the Fourier transform of this rectangular function. So the Fourier transform of this rectangular function is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity rect of t divided by tau times e to the power minus j times 2 pi ft times dt. Or from this we can write it as minus tau by 2 to tau by 2 1 times e to the power minus j times 2 pi ft times dt, because this function exists between the minus tau by 2 to tau by 2, right? And during that time, the value of this function is equal to 1. So if we further simplify it, then we can write it as minus 1 divided by j times 2 pi f times e to the power minus j times 2 pi f t with integration limit from minus tau by 2 to tau by 2. That is equal to 1 divided by minus j times 2 pi f times e to the power minus j times pi f tau minus e to the power j times pi f tau. Or we can write it as e to the power j times pi f tau minus e to the power minus j times pi f tau divided by 2j times pi f. So that is equal to sine of pi f tau divided by pi f. And if we multiply and divide this function by tau, then this particular function is equal to sinc function, because as you are aware, this sin x divided by x is nothing but the sinc function, that is equal to sinc of x. So from this, we can write this function as tau times sinc of pi f tau. Or if we write in terms of the omega, then it is equal to tau times sinc of omega tau divided by 2. So if we plot this function in the frequency domain, then it will look like this. And as you can see, This function is zero when the value of f is equal to plus minus n by tau, where n is varying from 1 to infinity. And from this we can say that these points are 1 by tau, 2 by tau and so on. Similarly, on the negative side, these points would be minus 1 by tau, minus 2 by tau and so on. So in this way, we can find the Fourier transform of the rectangular function. So these are the Fourier transform of some useful functions which will be helpful to us from the communication perspective. So in the next video, we will see some useful properties of the Fourier transform. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.